Hello, everybody. It's good to see you. And oh, now I have to make sure that you guys can speak. I just realized that. Just let me let you guys. Okay. And now you can unmute yourselves and you can speak like human beings. So,
hi.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello, Avocado.
Hi.
Ruta, hello.
We have such a small group today now.
Oh, but you know what? I know why. It's because I didn't admit everybody yet. So here we go.
And plus, we literally just started.
Yeah, that's the other reason.
Nice, yeah. Taco Cat is
here. Wow, participants doubled in size.
So let's start with some random people introducing themselves. Scott, I love that fish that you have. So please introduce your fish and yourself to everybody. That's just too cute.
Yeah, it's a frog. It's called a frog fish.
Wow. And
you can't see from the picture, but from its nose area, there's a little tentacle that goes out with a little gob on there. It's also called an angler fish because it's a fishing fish. So okay. It attracts little fish in front of it going after that little thing. And then like a frog, it jumps out and eats it.
Okay. Okay. Chai, could you introduce yourself? I know that I've seen you before. I saw your name on the Venn diagrams yesterday. So I know this is not your first one.
Hi, yeah, my name is Cynthia. I'm from Vancouver and on the traditional unceded territories of the Hunkaminam speaking people. And I'm a teacher and I'm really excited to be a part of this conversation and opportunity to do some problems with some young people. Thank you.
Great. Ruta and Nathan. So first, Ruta, introduce yourself. Tell me why, what's your favorite artist? That's what I'm going to say. Who is your favorite artist in all of your experience with art? Do you know any artists? Maybe you don't know any artists.
I don't really know.
Well, today the correct answer is that your favorite artist is Mondrian. Okay, so Nathan, it's your turn. Can you tell me why Mondrian is your favorite artist, Nathan?
Okay, I don't know anything about Mondrian, but does he do something with a bunch of math stuff or something?
I don't even know if he knew how to do 1 + 1, but we're going to use his paintings as an excuse to do some very interesting mathematics. So let us start. Here we go. I'm going to share my screen. And this is the first Wednesday puzzle time with Mo Math and Math Pickle. And here is the man of the hour. This is Piet Mondrian. And this is some of the art that he tended to do. So you probably have seen this kind of art around. And Piet Mondrian was the first artist to explore it. So here we see, we're not going to do the annotating quite yet. We might get to a point where we'll do that later on, but not right now. Okay. This is some of his art, and here is the Mondrian art puzzle. Here we have a 4x4 canvas, and we are here to help Mondrian. Imagine it's 100 years ago, and we have to help him because he doesn't exactly know the rules about how to create beautiful art, and we're here to help him. Do you think he's going to appreciate this help? Maybe not, but we're going to help him anyway. So here is the first question. I'm going to start off with red, and I'm going to get Nathan. I want you to tell me when to stop going across. I haven't told you the rules yet about how we're going to score this, but Nathan, you get to choose how far across we go. Just stay stop. Okay, so I'm going to say that we were stopping there. And next, we're going to go to avocado cream. You are going to start here, and you're going to tell me how far down we're going to go.
Okay. So
we can stop here or here or
stop.
All the way down?
No. Oh, okay. I'm like, that's, yeah, there.
If you stop there, you have automatically failed. You tell Mondrian he's failed because he has created two rectangles that are exactly the same rectangle. Like one's a 1x3, one's a 3x1. Those are the same rectangle. He has failed. Okay. So, okay. So that, do you want to choose again? Avocado cream?
Actually, what I wanted to say on like the second one down, but then you were going like too fast.
Oh,
yeah, there we go. Yeah.
All my fault. Yeah, don't blame Pete Mondrian. Blame me. I went too fast. Perfect. Okay. Ruta, what about here? How far across and how far down would you like to make this? Oh, stop right there. Before we even get started. Okay. Next, Roderick, we're here. How far across would you like to go, Roderick?
Can we go across and down?
Yeah. So we can go the whole way across.
One across and one down.
One across, one down. So we're going to make
just there and then down. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, good. Okay. Madeline. Oh, I love your cat, Madeline. That's so cute. Madeline, it's your turn. And let's say that I'm just going to grab some more of these squares here. And go ahead, Madeline. You get to decide what you want to do with this one. So yeah, you can tell me when to stop here. That's just a height one. Or you can go for a height two, or so those are your only two choices. So one or two, what do you want?
Two.
Okay. And Madeline, how far do you want to stop here, or do you want to go across two? So your choices are 2x2 or a...
Stop here.
Stop there. And have you guys succeeded? Has Mondrian succeeded here? No, he's got two rectangles exactly the same. This green one and this red one, exactly the same. So he's failed. We don't even score it. We just say, Pete, you have to go back to the canvas and you have to try this again because you don't even get a score. You have to have all of your rectangles different sizes. Okay. So I love cats. Go ahead. You're starting out. Tell me how far across to go with this first rectangle. We can go 1, 2, 3, or 4.
Four.
All the way across. All the way across. And how far?
And all the way down.
And all the way down. And is this an acceptable solution? No. This is a boring piece of art, and Mondrian didn't make boring pieces of art. So you have to, whenever you're creating one of these, helping Mondrian create his art, you have to at least have two rectangles. That's your minimal amount that you have to have. So, okay, that was a good thing to test. Okay. Jasmine, how far across would you like to go with this first one? 1, 2, 3, or 4?
2.
And how far down would you like to go? 1, 2, 3, or 4?
Two.
Okay. So you kind of have a Roderick style square there. Ruta, go ahead. What would you like to do with this one?
Two.
Two across and how far down?
Two.
Is that acceptable?
No, one more down.
One more. Yeah. Then it's okay. Then we're good. Stick person, hello again. Stick person, here you don't even get to choose to go up, you only get to go across. So how far across would you like to go? 1, 2, 3, or all the way 4 across? What would you like, stick person?
Four.
Four, all four? Okay. And then I think that we've got this last one here. And Tin Can. Hello, Tin Can. I love your creative names, kids. That's fun. Okay. Tin Can, do you want to go one across or two across? So for those of you who have arrived late, I haven't yet told the rules for how this puzzle is scored. All that I've told you is that you are not allowed to have two rectangles the same, not the same. So if I had this one by one here, then this one would have to be a one by one and that would be a fail. So Tin Can, I'm telling you, you don't want to stay a one by one. You want to do a two by one.
Yeah.
And now I am going to tell you guys how we are going to score each one of these Mondrian. Here's Mondrian. Here's this type of art. And we are now going to score for the very first time. We're going to tell Mondrian, here we go. Here is the score for this piece of artwork. Do you think he's going to listen to us? Well, probably not, but we're going to score it anyway for him. And the score is equal to the largest area of rectangle minus the smallest area of rectangle. Okay, so what's the largest area of rectangle here? It's 6 right here. Okay, and the smallest area of rectangle is, go ahead, Taco Cat.
If instead of a 4x1, we would have 3x1, and then we would have a 2x1 and a 1x1, then we would have gotten a bigger score.
Okay, well, let's do that in a second. First of all, what's the score here? Largest area minus smallest area?
4.
Yeah, it's 4. This is 6, largest area. And this is 2, the smallest area. And so Mondrian's score is 4. Okay, so Mondrian, you tell him a score of 4 is good, but we want to have as small a score as possible. A high score is bad in this puzzle. So there's a score of 4. Let's see if we can get a smaller score, or let's jump to a bigger grid. So Mondrian's not happy with a 4x4 anymore. He's now feeling expansionistic. He wants to try a 6x6 puzzle. Okay, here we go. So let's go with Nathan. Nathan, you are starting out. How far across and how far done for this first?
Let's do 5 across and 3 down. Actually, 4 down.
Wow. Yes. Like that. You're just taking over this entire grid, Nathan. Like that was not a subtle move.
Entire grid, but a lot of it. And I think it will get us a pretty low score.
Now let's see what happens. Okay. Well, Ruta, go ahead. How far down do you want to go with this one?
All the way down.
All the way down. And Solomon, what do you want to do here? So actually, I'm going to get Solomon to start. Solly, I'm going to get you to start in a second, because the best that you guys can do right now is just to fill in the whole thing. So we're going to start again. This isn't a very good score. Okay, I'm telling you right now, this is not a good score. What is it? It's the largest area minus the smallest area. You want a low score. 14. What's the largest area? It is 20. 5 times 4, that's 20. Minus the smallest area, that's 1 times 6, that's 6. So yeah, that score is 14. That is not good. So Solly, you are starting us out afresh. You are going to be trying something different, because okay. 14
so
was
I'm
way too high.
How many boxes do we have?
This is a 6x6 canvas that Mondrian is working
on. How many boxes are available?
You can make as many rectangles as you want, but no two rectangles can have the same dimension. So for example, you could have a 2x3 rectangle. Okay. But you can't have a 2x3 and a 3x2 rectangle. You could have a 2x3 and a 1x6. Okay, both of those multiply to 6. They have the same area, but they're different dimensions. Okay, so go ahead. What do you like here?
We will go three across.
Three across, done.
And four down.
And four done. Done. Okay. Next, tin can, go ahead. How far across and how far down would you like for this rectangle?
I want three squares across and three squares down.
Done. Okay. Kathy, what would you like for this one?
I think I want three squares across.
Yeah.
Three squares across and one square down.
Just one square, okay. Yeah, if you had gone three squares down, of course, these two would have been the same. So yeah, you made a wise choice. I'm just stopping there. Okay. Let's go to Taco Cat.
2 by 5.
Two across, or 5 across and then 2 down.
Yeah, 5 across and 2 down.
Okay. And I already know the last one. I'm just going to finish it off. The last one is this little 2 by 1. So what is your score, everybody? The last score that we had, the previous group got a score of 14, which was much too high. What about this score? What's the score here? So let's go. Oscar, go ahead. You joined late, Oscar, so I'm not sure if you understood the rules.
I don't. How does it work?
Okay, so the rules are largest area minus smallest area. So go ahead. What's the largest area of rectangle minus the smallest area of rectangle, Oscar?
The largest area is 10, is 12 minus correct. The smallest is 2.
10. You have just scored 10, Oscar. Low scores are better than high scores in this puzzle. So this is still not very good, but it's better than the previous canvas that Mondrian painted. Again, this is Mondrian, and this is the kind of art that he created. And we want, in these Mondrian art puzzles, we want to help Mondrian. Okay, I'm sure he's going to be very appreciative of that. 100 years ago, we're going to be helping Mondrian to create a low score. So here we've gone from 14 to 10, and now we're going to try to improve again. And let's see if we can get better than this. Ayan, go ahead. And then we'll go to the humanoid kitten. Yeah, but first of all, Ayan, what would you like for this first one here? How far across and how far down?
Make it 6 squares long and 4 squares down. No, 2 squares.
2 squares down, okay. Good. Jasmine, go ahead. Oh, and then I'm going to go for the humanoid kitten. Sorry, humanoid kitten, I jumped, but go ahead, Jasmine, your turn. How far across, how far down?
2.
2 across, and how far down? 1, 2, 3, or 4.
All the way to the bottom.
All the way to the bottom, okay. This looks hopeful. You know, right now, I look at this and I say, okay, this looks pretty good. Humanoid kitten, it's your turn. Go ahead. Tell me what your plans are for this one here. Oh, and actually, before humanoid kitten, before you speak, I want everyone to calculate what happens if we did this. If humanoid kitten just said, I want to fill up the rest of the canvas with blue, then I want to know the score. So I want you guys to calculate that quietly. You've got 7.5 seconds to calculate the score if humanoid kitten did this.
Would the score be 2?
That would be a pretty low score. So let's see. So the largest one.
The largest being minus the smallest.
This one is the smallest.
Okay, 16.
Oh, no.
Okay, 16 is the largest. And humanoid kitten, what is the smallest square? What's the area of the smallest? This is 4 by 4, which is 16. 8, yeah. So this is a lot better than what we've done before. We've got a score of 8, okay? But humanoid kitten, you might be able to do better than that. I don't know you can do better than that, but it's possible you can do better than that. So let's back up here and see what you can, if you want to, try again. I'm happy to start again as well, if you just want to start again. It's your choice. Okay, so I'm going to say that we're going to start again, we're going to be very happy with this score of 8. And humanoid kitten, we're going to go back to the start and see if we can do better, starting at this with this red up in the corner. You just tell me how far across that you want to go and how far down.
6 across. Yeah. And 2 down.
And 2 down. So starting similarly. Angie, you go ahead. How far, what kind of rectangle would you might like to make here? So first of all, tell me how far across and then how far down.
2 across.
2 across.
3 down.
3 down. There you go. Okay, at the very bottom, we have let's go for Vinod. Go ahead, Vinod. How far across would you like to go with this bottom rectangle? Again, the score is equal to the largest rectangle minus the smallest rectangle, and low scores are better than high scores. Go ahead, Vinod. Or Sully, if you want to jump in there.
I'm still thinking.
Okay, thinking is good.
What happens?
We allow thinking sometimes, occasionally.
If we go all the way.
Okay.
Then I believe that will be our smallest. We will get a...
You're thinking of this?
No, actually, make that smaller by 1.
Like this?
And then put a new one on that edge.
Okay. So like this.
And that would get us a score of 6.
Of 6. So that's that is a fantastic score. So I want people to verify that score. Okay. Oscar, you've got a comment?
Well, right now it's 9. But although if there wasn't that extra reason.
So just a second. So first of all, 9, where does that come from? That is, the largest rectangle is this 12.
And the smallest is the 3.
Oh, 12 minus 3 is 9. Right. So right now this is a score of 9. But you're suggesting,
if the yellow one went all the way across, went through all of them and the green disappeared, it would be a 6.
Well, that would certainly be, pretty small.
But then what happens if we have 2 12s?
Oh, we do have 2 12s. Are these 2 12s of the same dimension? No. These 2 12s and these 2 6s, we also have 2 6s. But they have different dimensions. One is a 2 by 3 6, and one is a 1 by 1 1 by 6 6. Okay, the 12s, one's a 2 by 6 and one's a 3 by 4. So these rectangles don't look the same. They've got different dimensions. You can't have a rectangle like, let me just erase this one here. Okay, just let me go with this. So we can't have two rectangles that look like this. these rectangles, this is a 2 by 3 and this is a 3 by 2, you can't have that. Those rectangles have got the same dimensions, they're just rotated. Okay, so this would be illegal. But here, all of the rectangles are different. You can't rotate them to make them land on each other. So these are different dimensions. So this is good. And a score of 6 is pretty remarkable. I will tell you, however, that I have worked hard on this and I've had students work hard on it. The best I found was 6, but one of my students found a result with 5. So it took a while, but somebody found a result with 5 on it. And I'm going to leave that with you. I don't think it's easy to find. So I'm just going to leave it. And if you find it, yeah, that's fun. You can share it with me next week. We are going to jump up to a much harder problem. This is whenever Mondrian chooses a 10 by 10 grid. So this is a monstrous size of a canvas that he's going to paint right now for us. And we are again going to score it for him because we are so friendly and we want to help him create better art. So there we go. We're going to start off right there. And let's go with avocado cream. Go ahead, avocado cream. How far do you want to push this one across the top? And then how far down for this first rectangle?
So I've just been so bad at talking today. What the heck? I can't. I guess you can go 3.
A hard decision. 3. Okay, there we go. It's and a hard decision. Mondrian's just like going, oh, it's so hard to decide. Yeah, you can imagine Mondrian actually making these decisions, saying, okay, I think this next rectangle I'm going to make a, and then he totally blanks out. Like I can see that happening 100 years.
And then you could go like down 3, I guess. Wait, what? What are you doing?
I'm just
like that. Yeah, okay. Like that.
Good.
3 by 3 square.
Roderick, do you want to contribute here to the next rectangle?
Sure. Let's go 9 down.
9 down. Oh my goodness. Okay. And how far across?
Just what we have.
Oh my goodness. It seems like Roderick might be a saboteur in our midst. What do you guys think?
Yeah, I'm trying to help.
This would be actually really interesting. What happens if one of the people is trying to make a low score? If it doesn't work at all, then everybody loses. But maybe Roderick is trying to make a high score and everyone else is trying to make a low score. That we maybe want to play that game afterwards. Okay. Let's go with Ruta. Go ahead, Ruta. What would you like to do with this yellow one here?
3. And then 2.
2, right. I guess this was, these two have got the same area. So if it was just these two, if it was just these two rectangles, then that would be 3 by 3, 9 by 1. Then the area would be, the score would be 0, which would be the best possible. One of the very interesting unsolved problems here is for a sufficiently large canvas, could the score be 0? And that is not known. Isn't that amazing? So yeah, this is an interesting, deep mathematical puzzle. Okay, Tackle Cat, go ahead.
Well, let's see. How about we do 3 by 4?
3 by 4? Okay. Stick person. Go ahead.
10.
All the way across. Yeah, I think that's a good move. I think that's a very, very good move. Tin can. Go ahead, tin can. What do you want for this purple one? How far across?
I want to go at 3 squares up.
3 squares up, okay. And how far across?
And 5 squares to the side.
Just there, right?
Yes.
Okay. Kathy, go ahead. Here, you just get to choose one thing, and that is how far up do you go, Kathy?
Nine, all the way up.
So if we go all the way 9 up, that's not going to be good because of Roderick's 9 going with the same color going down. So that would that's the only one that we shouldn't do. What should we?
One square down.
Good. Yeah, that's possible. Okay. Humanoid kitten. Go ahead.
Can you just do across all the way?
Yeah, I think that's a wise decision. This is already looking on the small side. Nathan, go ahead. Or this one.
Why not do a 4x4?
A 4x4. Now, there is an interesting choice. Jasmine, what do you want to do with this now?
Okay. So 4.
Okay. And let's see. I'm going to say that this last one, tin can, go ahead.
Four squares to the side.
4 squares. Oh, then we've got the same as this, right? We've got a 1x4 here and a 4x1 here. So those are the same dimensions.
Nathan,
yeah. Yeah. So
do 5.
Yeah. Yeah. I think 5's a good choice. So everybody take 10 seconds quiet to figure out your score. So we'll just be quiet for, let's make it 7.3 seconds. Okay, so Solly, what do you think? What's the score here? Which is your
largest? I believe it is 4 is 12.
Yeah, I think that looks right. So this is 4x4, that's 16. This is 1x4, that's 4. So
I think you can make it smaller, though. I mean,
go ahead. You've got a recommendation. Tell me which rectangles I should change.
So the biggest one is that red one.
So can we do this?
But that's not allowed. So you have to shrink it by 2.
Oh, we have to shrink it by 2. Right.
And then add another one right there.
Okay, so I'll wait. Okay, go ahead. Tell me what you want me to do.
Put that down all the way.
Down all the way, yes.
And add a new one to cover in that whole area.
This whole area? Well, I'll just copy this one, slide it over. There we go. And what's your score now?
Doesn't work.
Yeah, it doesn't work. Yeah, so this is, I'm just going to put an X here. X, 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 X. Okay. There
we go. Yeah, no.
Okay. Yeah, so that's a disaster. And yeah, it's sometimes fun to have.
I know something we could do. We could take the blue one and the red one next to it and make them go up by 1. The one less.
Okay, so maybe. Like this. Go up by 1, so like
no, 1 less.
1 less. Okay, like this and like this.
No, the other way.
Like
because that would enable them. And then keep the other red one the same as it was.
Got it. Okay, so the other one, red one, is like this.
And yep. We could make it go all the way to the bottom, and then the yellow one make it be a 2x3. Oh, no, that's not allowed.
Yeah.
And we can't have a new one because...
But if we do that, then we need to kind of do this here.
But we can't do it.
Oh, yeah, you can't do it. You're right. So I'm going to just put this X again. Here we go. X. Okay, here we go.
Murder.
Another disaster. So it's fun coming up with these disasters. For those teachers who are watching this either today or on another day, what is so great about this kind of puzzle? Whenever I'm talking to teachers, you guys go on, I'm not going to have everyone annotate because that's going to cause chaos. So I'm just going to stop the annotation for a second. And I'm just going to talk to teachers for a second here, and then I'll come back to you kids. So what's so good about this kind of puzzle is that it can simultaneously address those kids who are struggling at the bottom of a class and those kids who are just taking off. Because if you solve a 4x4 pretty well, then you can do a 6x6, a 10x10, a 15x15. And eventually you get to the point that even mathematicians don't know the answer. Even computer scientists don't know the answer. So this is I call these infinite puzzles, unlike puzzles like Sudoku, where you present a puzzle, but then you have to have some hints. With puzzles like this, you present the puzzle, and then you get an infinite number of puzzles instantaneously. And here we have an infinite number of sizes of canvas that Mondrian can be working on. Okay, back to you kids. And let's say yes to annotation. And what should we do here? Let's see, we've only got a few minutes left. So let me tell you where you can go to get some of these sheets to print out. You can get this sheet and this sheet to print out. And I'm just going to put into the chat where you can go. Let me just go here. Okay, so I'll just put into the chat. You can find these on MathPickle. On the last page of the slideshow on that chat will take you to, on the last slide, you're going to find a link to both of these and some more sheets to do with Mondrian art puzzles. Okay, you can also look up, if you just look up Mondrian Squares Riddle, you will find the same puzzle done on TEDx. And you will also find a number file video on Mondrian. So I think we're going to try it once more, and that will be it for today. So let's go back and
I had an idea about how we could go at this. Maybe if we started from the smallest squares, then that would kind of make the minimum possible of the biggest square. Although that would make the smallest square smaller. So if we could decide on some square that would be the smallest one, let's say 2x3, then we could start going up from there.
Okay, so I love your idea, Taco Cat. So this is exactly what we should be doing as problem solvers, as mathematicians, is trying different ideas. So your idea is to start with the smallest, and then we promise ourselves we will never get smaller than that. Taco Cat, tell me about what you want for the smallest one and where it should be. It doesn't have to be in the corner here.
Well, I guess, I'm not super like into this theme, so I don't know where it should be, but I guess like, I don't know, we could try a 2x3 or something.
Okay. Well, let's try a 2x3. And for now, we'll just try it in the corner. We'll see if we need to change that. Scott, would you like to give a rectangle starting here?
Maybe a 3x3.
3x3, okay. Humanoid kitten. Oh, I don't see you there, humanoid kitten. So if you're gone.
I am here. It's just that my avatar isn't showing.
Okay. Go for it. What do you want to do here? So we're following Taco Cat's idea. So our smallest area is 6. So you can never choose, no matter what rectangle you're choosing to paint here, it can never have an area less than 6. Go ahead.
Can you go across 3 and down 4?
Yep, across 3, down 4, done. Okay, let's go, Ruta. Go ahead, what would you like?
Maybe a 3
across
and 3 down. Wait, 4 down.
4 down. Okay. And stick person. Taco Cat. Yeah, Taco Cat. Figured that these two are the same. And we can't do it the 3x3 because then these two would be the same. And we can't do it like this because then these two would be the same. Oh my goodness. So this is irritating.
I noticed that I think maybe we're going a bit too fast and going up. Like we didn't have a 7 and we didn't have like an 8. So maybe if we just did +1.
Okay. So,
well, it just, you don't have to do that, just how my theory.
That seems a really smart idea. So instead of completing this grid, what we're going to do is we're instead going to look at all of the shapes that are bigger than 6x6 or the same size. Okay, so we have this here. This is also a 6, area 6. And what about an area 7? What would that look like? Okay, I think there's only one way to do an area 7, and it's like this. An area 8. How many different ways are there to do an area 8? How many different shapes of a rectangle can make an area 8? So Taco Cat's idea, I think, is an interesting one. He doesn't want to jump all over the place. He doesn't want to go from an area 6 to an area 12. Instead, he wants to methodically think, okay, I don't want to make huge jumps. The score is equal to the largest area minus the smallest. So let's try to make small jumps. Let's think of all of the possible rectangles. So for example, here would be one of the area 8. The other area 8 is of course just the straight line. Straight line. I shouldn't say straight line. There's a straight number of squares in a row. Okay. So this is a really good methodical way to think about the problem. And I'm not sure if it's going to work, if it's going to help, but this is the type of thinking, Taco Cat, that I really like to see. It might not be more helpful than just doing what we've been doing, but thinking systematically, I wonder if this is going to help. I wonder if this is going to make our lives easier. Oh, that's great. Whether it works or not, we'll see. Good. Well, I think that ending with a, let's, what did we end with here? We ended with a score of XXXXXXXXX. And this one, we also ended up with a score of XXXXXXXXX, which didn't work. So ending off in a failure, I think, is really sweet. We need to have more failures in our math classes. And so ending off as a failure, I think that's a fun way to do it. So I will see you guys next week, or for those of you coming to other puzzle times, remember that these puzzle times, even though the grade 2 puzzles on Monday, even those grade 2 puzzles are meant for grade 2 students to understand, it does not mean they're easy. Just like this can be perfect for grade 4 students working with multiplication, it doesn't mean that mathematicians find this an easy puzzle to solve. Okay, I will see you guys next week, and till then, take care.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Thank you.
Thank you.